Hi, moms and tweens. Let's talk real life. Getting your period never seems to be the right time, especially your first period. I remember being in middle school and thinking, why is this happening? Even though I knew about it, that it was going to happen, what was happening to my body or what products to use, it just didn't feel like the right time. But eventually I accepted that it's a natural part of life. So as you're going through this journey of your growing and changing body, I want you to embrace that it is beautiful and that you're beautiful. So I thought of doing this video, an easy DIY period kit to go, tweens edition, so that you can use it at a slumber party, when you're hanging out with friends, at sports activities, at a family reunion. I want you to be prepared so that when that time of the month comes, it will be easier. The first thing that you're going to need for your tween period kit is a bag. So in this particular kit, I'm going to have two bags. One is the main bag and the other is the smaller bag where you can, if you're example at school and you're going to go to the bathroom to change, you can put stuff from here into here and then just bring this one because this is a smaller bag. Now in the version, the first version I made a few years ago for my daughter, it was one bag, but within the bag there was a removable bag in it, so that's the smaller bag that she could take to the bathroom. So that's kind of like how I like it, but it's up to you. You can have just one bag and bring the whole thing. Just make sure that it's a bag that fits, like, let's say your backpack, your locker, your desk, what you have, especially at school, because most of the year you're in school. So those are the hours where you're there the most. And so you want to be prepared for that type of situation. Okay, let me make a disclaimer. As far as medications, that's up to you, what you and your family or your parents are comfortable with you bringing. Now, I know at schools that they don't allow you to have over-the-counter medication, I think, with you. And so you'd have to sign whatever you need to sign at the nurse's office to allow you to use those medications for when you need them. But maybe for other schools, it's no problem. I know for our school, it wasn't really a problem. And so my daughter carried a little bit of medication, although she didn't really use it. So also, don't share medication, even if it's over the counter. It's just better to be on the, it's just safer, so that if there's anything that happens to your friend or to that person that you share medication with, or even over the counter, then you're going to feel really bad. It's better to let that person go to the nurse and find help there. The second thing that you will need in your period kit are the pads. Okay. Oops. The pads. And so this brand is Pinky, and this has great reviews. The nice thing about this is that it has three sizes. So for the heavier, you know, regular, and then lighter days. And it's, you could see the designation is by color, and it comes with the bag. So once this is used, let's say there's, you don't want to use toilet paper, or there's not enough toilet paper, then you could just go ahead and put the used one in the bag, and then this can be thrown into the garbage. The third thing that you'll need are period panties. And this particular brand, Inerzy, I think, In Jersey. Okay, this is on Amazon. Everything I have is in Amazon. I'll link it below. Make sure to check that out. And my Amazon store will have the whole list there too. So these are tween size. They start at size 8. So 8 to 10, 10 to 12. And they are a pack of three, and in different colors. I think this one had green, and there's maybe like a pink and then a white with black polka dots. So they're cute. And but the main thing is they're very functional, because the main concern I know for me was always like leakage, like accidents. And they do happen, but you try your best, right? That's why we're making this period kit. So this has like that extra padding, I guess I'd say, that kind of catches the leaks. Now, it's not going to be for like the whole period. You still need the pad, but this will help with leakage, which I think will help you be confident and not so worried, because those were always my worries. Number four, you're going to need a heating patch. So they have, you know, patches for grown-up size. And I like this. This is by Happy Moon. And again, I'll put the links below because it's a smaller size. And so basically you take this and you know, it's like a sticker, and you put it here where the cramps are, and it gives that warmth, that heat, you know, just like any other heated patch. It helps just bring comfort, you know, to help with those symptoms that they may subside, or maybe it's just a matter of maintenance, and then just to get you home. I remember that, like, I'm just like, just get me home so I can lie in bed. And that might be the answer, just to give you enough comfort to get through the day. Okay, so let's say you have to change your underwear because there was leakage, or you just want to feel fresh. You'll need a baggie. So the easiest thing is to just use a Ziploc. This is the sandwich size. And you know, you might put your dirty underwear here. So what I like to do is to just have a paper towel to make it not see-through. I just prefer that. And then it could also be used to soak up anything, or if you have to wipe anything extra, or just so that your underwear has something to, like, this could soak in whatever on your underwear. So it would just be like this, and you could put it in your bag here. Another thing is you can use a paper bag like this. This is very cheap. You know, if you don't want to use the Ziplocs, you can even cut it in half. So it would just be this size, but it's just enough to cover your underwear enough, you know, to bring it home and wash it. I also have this. This is another sandwich bag. Now, this is, these are pretty cheap too. It has a little bit of a wax in there, so it does protect it from, like, soaking out of the paper bag, because that might be a concern with this type of bag, that it might soak out a little bit. You just have to be careful of what it touches. This one will kind of protect it a little bit more, and this one for sure will protect it. Okay, number six is wipes. So let me show you the inside of the bag already. A lot of it has wipes. So example, this is wipes for number two. Okay, and this is a nail polish remover wipe. And the reason I put these different types of wipes is so that you just feel good. But the main wipe, here's another one, is face and hand wipe. You just want to feel fresh. But this is the main wipe, where it's like a feminine wipe to wipe down there. Those are the things to think about. And then this is also a deodorant wipe. The reason I like wipes is because it saves space. Look at how thin they are versus a travel size bottle, whether you buy it at the store or have a refillable one. They will help in giving you more space in your bag when you put it in. Number seven is body spray. So you can get a travel size. I like this refillable one. It comes in different colors. So what you do, there's a hole down here. So if you have a larger bottle of body spray or perfume, I like to use body spray. It's a lot lighter. And I think they have the sale once a year at Bath and Body Works. So I get a few of them, and they last all year. So you just take the tip off, and you know that little tube, you just pump it and it goes in, and you can see here, it shows the amount of body spray left or perfume. And you open it like this, and just give a spray, and it's really nice. It helps you feel clean, so you can spray it once or twice a day just to keep you feeling good during the day. Number eight is hand sanitizer. So I have the one from Touchland, and it has different scents. And it comes like this, and this is a silicone cover that goes with it, and it has a key ring. So the reason I got the cover is to protect the bottle, but also I like the key ring on it. So you don't have to put it in the bag. You could put it as part of your keychain, somewhere else in your backpack, but it's just nice to make sure you have a hand sanitizer available for you. Maybe when you use the restroom at school, usually there's soap, right? And but sometimes you might be in a restroom where there is no soap, and so at least you have the hand sanitizer with you. Number nine is lip balm and lotion, or something that will help you not be dry, whether it's for your lips or your hands, maybe even your face. I have this which is a cute lip smackers. So look at a little bunny. Isn't that the cutest thing? Okay. And then that's your lip balm. And as far as lotion, you can always get a travel size one like this. This one comes in different scents, so I love that. And so throughout the day, once or twice a day, just put some lotion so keep you from being dry. Number 10 is chocolate and candy. So the thing with when you have a little bag, you just have to have the individual size candy. So here I have like the Sour Patch Kids. This is watermelon flavor. They have those bags that they come with different flavors. So you want to have a little variety, or you can have like little chocolates like this, like Ghirardelli. That is the raspberry, dark chocolate raspberry, and white chocolate caramel. Is it what? Oh, milk chocolate caramel. One thing about having your period is it was always a reason, shouldn't say excuse, a reason for me to have chocolate. And I tell you, there's something about having chocolate when you have your period that just is comforting, just makes you feel better. So have some chocolate and candy in your bag, not too much, just enough to, give you a boost, a mood boost during the day. I also want to show you this book. It's called The Period Book, A Girl's Guide to Growing Up. I think this is great to read. It has a lot of information. It's also encouraging. It's great to read with your parent, whether it's your mom, your dad, or your guardian. And it acts like a guide. So instead of just kind of bringing up information, whatever information, it's nice to go through the book together and discuss it together. You can also read it with your friends. But it's when my daughter was growing up, that's what I did, was we read a book together, and it was a great way to have discussion and answer questions so that the book was the guide, the source, versus me. It was just a lot easier that way for me as a parent. So hopefully that's a good tip for you. This is what the bag looks like inside. It has this little section with a little bit of a separation. And so what I put there in that little area are the things for like toiletries or, the pampering stuff. So let's say the lip balm, the lotion, the body spray. Okay. And I also have a hairband here. If you just want to pull your hair away from your face, you can also have a hair tie, scrunchie, bobby pins, whatever you want to put in there, and obviously fits in the bag. And look at this. Found this cute Tic Tac, and I'm going to put it here because it fits more in that little section. Then I have the hand sanitizer, so I'm going to put that over here. Okay, and then I take the two pads, put them first. Maybe you have three or four, depends on what you need for that day. And then I put the wipes in order of like larger to smaller, right? So I just take the heat patch, fold it in half. Okay, and then I have this also, and this is toilet seat covers. Okay, there are 10 in each. There are 10 in one packet. And what happens when you open it up, there's actually two sections. So there's five here, five here. So what I did was I took out the five from here. And so that, you don't need more than five in a day. So you can always replenish it. And I have this stain rescue for your clothing that, if you need that, it's here. And so that's also something if you want to put in the other bag, you can. So there, I have the two pads, the heat patch, the toilet seat cover, and then the different wipes, right? So I put that in order like this. See? Ooh, I love how that stacks. Okay, and then we're going to put it into the bag, kind of more towards the right, so that there's a section here for the candy and the chocolates. Okay, so there. And then I just take my chocolates and my candies. Yum, yum, yum. Hey, listen, treat yourself, right? Okay, so it's there. And I'm just going to put the chocolate over here. And it fits perfectly. And just, straighten it up, as best as you can. That's what it looks like. So when you're looking above it, you see everything there. It's all accessible. It's not like, you know, you can't find stuff. Okay. But it's a small enough bag. You know what's in there. So look how cute that bag is. I mean, the design. Okay. And then as far as this small bag, for me, again, this is the one, like, let's say you know you're going to have to, you need to change your underwear. So bring this one. It's smaller, but of course you can bring the whole thing. You can bring both. You can do whatever. But if you have to just bring something smaller because you can't bring a lot of stuff to the bathroom or you don't want to, you have this one, which has the extra underwear, right? It has a pad. It has the feminine wipe. And then you could put a stain rescue there. And then it has the baggie. So you change your underwear, you put it in here, fold it up, put it back into the bag. And now it's discreet, right? And you just bring it home, obviously, and wash the underwear. Then now you have the fresh underwear that you put on. You have the pad that you put on, and then you use the wipe. So now you have this left, and this is what you bring back to wherever you were from the bathroom. Let me know in the comments below what you liked about these bags and what you will be implementing into your own period kit to go. Also, leave me a comment if you have any questions, if you want to share any stories. Let's help each other in the community. And if you want to see 10 essentials for my beach bag that you could use in yours, click the next video.